Hi guys, today we have a classic problem. A PlayStation 4 with the dreaded blue light of death issue. Yep, it's not looking good for this one, but don't panic just yet. Not all blue light of death issues are the same. So I'm going to walk you through the steps to bring this one back to life. Grab yourself a coffee, stick around, and let's get it sorted. Into this PS4 Slim, what happens is when, let's just get you in focus, when you push the power button here, I don't know if you'll be able to see that, if you watch it, it goes blue, but then it flicks off again. So just do that again. So plug the power supply. Plug the power supply back in again. Just try and get you a little bit closer and a little bit more in focus. Push the power button. Shows a blue light for literally a split second. And then it disappears again. Now, this is quite a common issue, actually, on the PlayStation 4s. There's a number of different types of blue light issues, right? So there's a quick blue light. There's a 2 or 3 second blue light, and then there's a long pulsing blue light issue. So a long pulsing blue light issue is more than likely something to do with the motherboard or a component on the motherboard. 9 times out of 10, that's the APU, which is faulty. When you get like a 2 to 4 second blue light, again, that could be an issue with a component on the motherboard. It could be an issue with hard drive. But when you get a very quick blue light, like this one, 9 times out of 10 is the actual power supply. So the PS4 is trying to draw power from the power supply, and there's an issue with the power supply, and it literally just cuts out again. And that's kind of what we're experiencing here. So what we're going to do, we are going to test that theory, and we are going to open up this PlayStation 4 Slim. So this will probably be a relatively quick video. So the casing pops off just like so. There's 4 screws on this one you need to take out. So these 2 screws at the back here are Phillips screws. So they come out. And these front 2 screws here, they are Torx or T screws. So that side comes out. And then this one comes out like so. Then what we need to do, spin the PlayStation around, and you'll see over here is a hard drive cover. So you just literally slide that sideways, off that pops. Then behind that, there's a Phillips screw which holds the hard drive in place, or the hard drive caddy at least in place. Unscrew that, pull this little tab here sideways, and the hard drive will come out, but that's somewhere nice and safe. Behind this warranty sticker here, there's a screw. This PlayStation's already been opened. 1 screw here. Take that screw out and then remove the bottom cover. So that simply just pops off like the front cover. So grab it on its sides just here, like so, and then just lift it up like that, and then the casing will come off, and then pull it towards yourself, right? So by the front, so it's kind of lips over the front. Right, to get the power supply out, what we need to do is take out this screw here as well, because that's the only screw that's underneath here, hence why we had to take the bottom plate off, which is connected to the power supply, so that 1 screw there. And then what we can do, flip it back over, kind of put your fingers just underneath the little sides here of the power supply, give it a bit of a wiggle, and then the power supply will pop out. Don't pull it up straight away, because there is a cable just here connected to it, just there. So then very carefully undo that cable from the power supply, like so, off that pops. And then what we need to do is come in with our new power supply. So coming in with the new or replacement power supply, And basically, just fit in, right? So it's just the reverse of replacement. So get your cable down here, and then just connect it into the connector on the power supply. Slide it in, and then just click it home, like so. Slide the power supply around, and then just drop it into place. Give it a bit of a wiggle, right? And just push it down, like so. It's obviously always best to clean up. This one's quite dusty. I'll clean it up after, right? But I just want to quickly show you how to do this. Shield back on. Tighten up the screws again. Come in with our Phillips screws and then just pop them into place and give them a tighten as well. Flip it around, not forgetting the one screw that we took out earlier. Pop that one back in. And then you can pop your casings back on again. Easiest way to do this, start at the front here. Lay it over like so, and then just hook it over the front of the PlayStation. With your thumbs, push it back, and then click it down into place. Your screw for the case. Just move the warranty label out of the way, if your warranty label's still there. Come in with your T screwdriver. I believe this is a T8. And then just tighten that up. Like so. While you're here, get your hard drive and pop your hard drive back in. Easiest way to remember, you'll see on the hard drive there's a metal bracket which has actually got the screw hole in it popping out. That goes outwards like that because that's where it screws into. Slide it in like so. Push it all the way home and then get your screw, which was holding the hard drive in place, or the hard drive caddy in place. Get the plastic cover. Pop that into place. Again, it's a reversal of the way you took it off, right? To put it back on again, just put it roughly on top and then just slide it that way. And off it will go. Get your top cover. Only goes one way around. Again, just hook it over the back first of all, like so. Give it a bit of a wiggle, and then it'll just click down in place. Right, so let's see if that has actually fixed it. I believe it will be just a power supply. All right, so we'll plug it back in again. Let's keep an eye on the blue light. Click our power button. As you see this time, the blue light is staying on. It's starting to flash. And that eventually will go to a white light as well. So there you go, real quick video on how to fix a fast blue light of death issue on a PlayStation 4 Slim. Exactly the same for a original PlayStation 4 as well. As I say, this won't fix the long blue light of death issues because 9 times out of 10, they are issues, say, with components on the motherboard or the APU itself. There you go, we're at a white light now. Hope you found the video useful. Real quick one this week. If you did, please consider subscribing to the channel and giving us a thumbs up. It really does help us out if you interact with the video and give us a thumbs up. So please consider subscribing and giving us a thumbs up because it helps us out immensely. So that's enough from me this week. Hope you're all well. Take care of yourselves and see you in the next one.